What's up, y'all? It's me, Erica. It's Wednesday. We are down here. What are we doing? What are we talking about? I have nothing to talk about. Come on, Jay-Z. A little Jay-Z this morning. Girls all over the world. Yes. Okay, y'all, so where do I want to park in a different place? I kind of don't want to park right there. I'm going to park right there. No, let me park up here. Let me go with my first mind, girl. Go with your first mind, girl. Trust your little instinct. Because it'd be like... So listen, I don't have anything to talk about. So I guess we're going to just talk about observations that I've made over the past couple of days. That's the reason why I didn't come down. It's been very slow in the news week. And the things that are happening, I don't find interesting enough to kind of talk about, you know. I saw that Tory Lanez went live last night. I'm not sure what about. I haven't watched it. I guess, you know, he's already had his arraignment or whatever. They said that was on the 13th. So I don't know. So maybe he can talk now. Maybe he could talk now. His lawyer probably told him, don't say nothing until you actually talk to the courts. And then you can come down and say whatever it is you want to say, you know, try to absolve yourself and make yourself look like you don't have nothing to do with it. I thought about it and I said at the end of the day, the only person left is Kelsey. So did Kelsey shoot, you know, her friend? You know, I mean, stranger things have happened. So we'll see what's going to happen. And then I was watching a video, someone reviewing The Real Housewives of Potomac. And I know we're tired of talking about, you know, this fight that Candace and Monique have. And I heard that Monique came down on some after show or something and was like appalled at the idea that Candace would actually go down to the courthouse and file charges against you, knowing that you have 3 kids and a husband and a brand and you're a socialite and all this other stuff. She didn't say all that, but
the childishness of it all, to take something legally that you know you played a part in and then try to sue me, possibly, and then want to see me in jail. I have to say that I was probably expecting to hear from Monique. I was expecting her to call me or text me because I just knew. I just knew that it would be, yeah, you know, girl, I lost my cool. You know, we were having a back and forth and it became, you know, something that I should have walked away from. You look at Candace a little bit like, you did that? Like, you would actually do that? Knowing everything that's at stake for Monique? I got 3 whole kids here. And for her to go down that road, to me, was just so unnecessary. It was very nasty. And it really just showed her true character.
She said, you know, she mentioned her children. And I thought to myself, I'm like, okay, it's so odd that when someone is, you know, you could look at in a fight to say like, okay, they got into a fight and Candace lost the fight. Okay. And, you know, this idea that, you know, you can't get in a person's face, right? Which I still don't think that Candace was in Monique's face from my vantage point. I said this morning, I really hope they show raw footage at the reunion. I know they probably don't want to see it, but I feel like Candace was standing in front of Monique when they were all talking together. She backed up to, you know, do her little, I'm sleep, girl. You mad over nothing because you out here making up bullshit that don't even make sense. Girl, I'm sleep, right? Everybody is bored with this, whatever it is that you're trying to come up with, girl. We're out here and we're bored and we're sleep. Right? And then she walks back to where she was originally standing and she's doing all this and Monique is doing all this. So I don't think that she had her hand in her face no more than Monique was using her hands to communicate. So that's it for that. This idea that, well, you can't, what are you guys saying? You can't be responsible. We always say, right? You do something to somebody, you cannot be mad at how they react, right? And so in the rationale that some people are using is that Candace got in her face. The rationale is you can't be accountable for what somebody else does when you get in their face or when you provoke them. Oh, let me write down Portia's name too. forgot about her slow ass. My thing is, if Candace got in her face and the natural course of action was to get your ass whooped, right? You down here, you end up fighting your good girlfriend. And then as a response, you hear she doesn't have any remorse for what she did to you, right? You go down to the courthouse. Now, should Candace have thought about Monique's children as she traipsed into the courthouse? Or should Monique have thought of her own goddamn children when she decided to take the fight, when she made a decision in her mind to take this a little bit further than flipping hair? So why is it, now this is what I wrote this morning. So because Candace has so much mouth, people need to leave her alone. Because there's this thing going around, and it seems a theme. And I was talking about it with Diva yesterday. I feel it's the same energy with Candace and Monique that we had with Portia and Kenya. This idea that when you, and with Portia and Kenya, the response, to me, I would be like, okay, I understand. I get why Portia lost control, because Kenya was doing a lot, right? She wasn't not just speaking loudly, she was talking shit, but it was so loud that the girl's like, girl, shut the fuck up, and that's it, right? I can understand. Was Portia out of line? Was Kenya wrong? That to me was like, oh, two people engaging and then one took it too far. When you hear the story back, you can be like, oh, okay, I get it. But when somebody tells me the story back between person A and person B, Monique and Candace, I'm like, I don't quite understand the response to black out, angry and black out, and then to come back and say like she's been asking for this. I don't get that. Okay, like I said, Candace has so much mouth, people need to leave her alone. This idea that the girls who don't fight and who don't fight and have words to use that are just as harmful as your fist, right? But everybody said, oh, she's verbally assaulting her. I don't know how she was verbally assaulting her by saying she was asleep. I'm asleep, girl. You making up bullshit. You coming up with bullshit and we're bored. Right? Right? Then you say Candace has too much mouth. And then we look at the last episode. See, she hasn't learned her lesson. Her husband had to tell her to be quiet. Let me tell you something. If you talk to me crazy, if you don't want me to cut your damn knees off with my words, don't say shit to me. Okay? The same way, if you don't want Monique to whoop your ass, don't say shit to Monique. It's the same thing. So if everybody knows that Candace's mouth is reckless, stop talking to Candace. Stop talking shit to her. Then she won't talk shit to you and hurt your damn feelings. Ashley, you shouldn't have said anything. And I don't understand now that the woman has been beat up, right? She lost the fight, according to y'all. She lost the fight. It didn't look like a mutual fight. It looked like a fight, right? I got you, girl. I got the best of you. Monique had the best of Candace, and we're not going to sit up here and lie and trying to make it seem like it wasn't as bad as it looked or whatever. So I said, so because Candace has so much mouth, people need to leave her alone. If you don't like her mouth, don't say shit to her. You black out because this woman said something to you. You blacked out. And you're so triggered. Because Candace has so much mouth. Kenya has so much mouth. Kelly Dodd has so much mouth. Heavenly has so much mouth. Dorinda has so much mouth. These are girls who use their words to fight. And if you can't spar with words with a girl who has a vocabulary to tear your ass down, then you need to walk away. Because you can't go to court and say, she was talking shit to me, so I blacked out and beat her ass. The judge is going to be like, girl, you sound fucking crazy. There's no excuse. Yeah, you lost control. There's no excuse for beating her up just because she told you, we're asleep because we're bored with you making up shit. And a year later, you still making up shit. If she has too much mouth, don't say shit to her. Then you won't have to fight her. I don't know why everybody can go around saying whatever they want to Candace and Candace can't respond. It's almost like it's okay for you to victimize, brutalize, beat up, and everything. She can get beat up, but she can't go to the courthouse? What is she supposed to do? Just let it go? I'm not letting it go. You know why I'm not letting it go? Because you don't have any remorse. Now, if I heard you felt bad for what you did, maybe I wouldn't have took my ass down to the courthouse. Whether the both cases have been dismissed, I think Candace, it was more of a gesture than, bitch, watch what decisions you make with your hands and you will not be in jeopardy to lose your freedom. Because me talking shit, there might be consequences, and the consequences might be me getting into a fight. And like I told Diva the other day, from where I'm from, if you got some mouth, you better know how to fight. You better know how to fight, because everybody can't fight with words because everybody doesn't have the vocabulary. Portia, I don't even know why Portia's opinion was even solicited. She's no one. She was in the same boat as Monique. She actually felt immediately embarrassed for herself. I can't believe she took me there. I can't believe that bitch took me there. And to this day, I don't know why Kenya talks to you. I don't know why Kenya talks to you. And like Rodney said this morning, bitch, you down here trying to rationalize and justify violence against a black woman, but you walking for Breonna Taylor. Girl, go sit your fake ass down. And that's the reason why Kenya said your ass is fake. You're performing. And you're going to get down there and try to mention that a Candace threw a butter knife at Ashley, another person, to justify why Monique... I don't know what happened. The phone just went off, child. I hope it's not too... I don't know what's going on. Mercury is in retrograde. That's all I got to say. I said, I don't know why everybody can go around saying whatever they want to say to Candace and Candace can't respond. It's almost like it's okay to victimize and brutalize black women, but when they respond, they can't be hurt. They can't be upset. They can't be emotional. They can't be traumatized. They can't be hurt by what happened to them. They should just let it go. It's okay for violence to be enacted upon her, but she can't respond to the violence by going to the law and saying, hey, you know, I got into this altercation, the woman assaulted me, and here it is. Candace can't be traumatized. Candace can't put sticky notes on the wall. Candace can't be waking up in a panic. It's okay for the violence to be inflicted upon you, but how you respond to the violence, no one likes how you respond to violence against you, Candace. Because they feel like it was warranted, like you needed your ass whooped. And I'm trying to figure out, how do you justify triggered, blacked out anger with no justification, no reason, no remorse, and not expect somebody to say, oh, you don't feel bad for what you did? Let's see if these niggas with handcuffs and batons and a history of violence, let's see how they respond to you. Since you don't feel bad about what you did. And does Monique have to feel bad? No, she doesn't. She don't have to feel bad. But to me, I feel like when you're making up a bunch of excuses for what you did, instead of being like, I don't have no remorse. People who have no remorse don't make excuses because they just don't have any remorse. She got in my face. She's been talking shit. I'm mad at her because And y'all know that, you know who was sitting next to Ashley and in between Ashley and Dottie at that table? Charisse. Charisse was at Wendy's Cameron Sippency. That's another reason why Monique wasn't invited. Because guess what? Now you have two people in the friend group who you have at odds with. You're at odds with. Only people you're not at odds with is Karen and Ashley. And Ashley, like I said, you guys would frown on a man. All these men who come out and defend men when a man has been accused of raping a woman, all these men who weren't there, who come out and defend the man against the woman without sight unseen, we frown upon that. You don't know what this person is doing outside of your view. You can't speak to the character of Russell Simmons when he's not in your view, when you can't see what he's doing, when he's luring somebody up some stairs into his apartment and then forcibly putting himself onto them. You can't defend that. You weren't there. We say the same thing to men. So the same energy is going to Ashley. You were not there. And if you're using our issue to try to figure out, try to deduce like, oh, what could have happened? You, my dear, have been the worst of them all. To Karen, to Giselle, to Robin, to Monique. Candace hasn't done a quarter of what Miss Ashley Darby has done, okay? Like I said, I'm rewatching the episodes and I'm watching. So my thing is, if y'all know this bitch has hands, don't talk shit to her, but don't talk shit. If you got hands and you talking shit to somebody with words and I get you together with my words and you fight me because you can't hang, you don't have the vocabulary, you're triggered again. Every time you're triggered, I understand my triggers. Did you understand your triggers when you were talking to your pastor about how Giselle triggered you? Were you triggered when you put that umbrella to Robin's throat? And Robin was provoking you. Come hit me, bitch. Come and do it right here. And was in your face. But you didn't do to Robin. Now, when you say somebody was in somebody's face, Robin was in Monique's face. Now, that is getting in your face. Not with a table in between, and I'm going like this, and I'm talking with my hands, and I'm expressing myself. You're not going to use that as an excuse to beat my ass, even though you did, and everybody's accepting it. But when Robin was in your face and was like, bitch, hit me, and you turned around and said, it's not worth it. It's not worth it because I don't want you and Juan living in my house. You want to take my money. And then you turn around and accuse Candace of wanting money from you. Yes, I want money from you, bitch. But like Ashley told Candace, why the fuck do I need money? My mama is rich. I don't have to sit on old Viagra dick for money. I was born into it. What else you got going on? So I don't need the money, bitch. This is letting you know, yes, I want your money because I'm coming for your ass because you put your fucking hands on me, bitch, and you really didn't have no fucking reason. And just like you sat down and talked to Ashley about her saying that you was a drunk bitch driving into ditches, and just like you sat down with Robin and gave her a hug and hugged her, how come Candace wasn't extended that same courtesy? Your sister. You called Charisse your sister too. Charisse was your sister. And Chris sat behind you on the reunion and said, I like Charisse out of all of them. And here we go again. I like Candace and Chris. So something is missing because you keep falling out with your sisters, Monique. You fell out with Gigi. You known Gigi since before Housewives. You done fell out with Charisse. You done fell out. You done beat Candace's ass. I would never speak to you again, bitch. Never. And wouldn't film with you. Do you think Giselle wants to film with you? Robin might film with you. Karen might film with you. You need to take a break. Because in a show, in an environment where we use our words to battle, if you are triggered by words, this is not the environment for you. If you are triggered by words and you need to take it to the streets, this is not the environment for you. The streets are on VH1. These are the suburbs down here. Yes, the girls lose control. Teresa, Lisa Rinna, who else? Bitches throwing glasses and shit. We've seen the girls lose control. Have we seen them lose control and beat each other up? There's no security on the Potomac set because why? They don't fight. But guess what? Now we have somebody who, in an environment where the women argue and have conflict and have lunch, we're in an environment now. We got somebody in our midst, girls. We have someone in our midst, girls, who is triggered by words. So be careful what you say to her. We got to be mindful of what we say to Monique now because Monique is easily triggered, honey. She's a dog. She's a dog. She's controlled by words and she moves into fighting action, blacked out anger when somebody says words to her. So be mindful of what you say to Monique Samuels because she'll beat your ass and run after you afterwards and then not expect you to press charges when she tells you she don't have no remorse. I don't understand why everybody, and oh, you see, Candace didn't learn her lesson. What's the lesson? That you guys can talk to her any kind of way, and I cannot even believe that it makes it seem like I'm Team Candace and what I said yesterday on Twitter. A lot of people seem like Team Candace. Whoever was on the other side of Monique's hand, we would be saying Monique is wrong. It don't matter that it's Candace. It could have been Karen. It could have been Wendy. It could have been Giselle. It could have been Ashley. It could have been anybody. Monique was wrong in an environment where we battle with words. You cannot put your hands on anybody, bitch. You just can't do that. And this has been a theme with Monique since season 2. Her first tagline was, I know I'm rough around the edges, but diamonds are too. You rough around the edges and you want to be accepted. And like your pastor told you, what you are modeling as perfection, these women are not impressed. And when those women were laughing at both you and Monique and you and Candace, when Candace was doing her theatrics and running around and spinning around, the women that you want to show that you're perfect to were laughing at you. So you were going to let them know, oh, bitch, you got bitches laughing at me now? Because I'm out here trying to be a socialite in Potomac. And now you got these bitches laughing at me. Oh, bitch, we about to fight. Because I'm not going to let it go down that you're getting the best of me with your words. And the only course of action I know how to do is to fight. Because that's where I'm from. This is not the environment for you. Should Monique take a break? Yes, bitch. Teresa went to jail and took a break. You're not going to lose your position. You're not going to lose your position. Don't worry about it. Candace didn't learn her lesson. Ashley, if Ashley had minded her business and just ate her food at that table, then Candace would not have said, oh, not for long. You ain't gonna be married for long, bitch. Is she paying you too? Why do I need to get paid? I'm a millionaire. Monique, why does Candace need to get paid? Her mother is rich. Her father is rich. Her stepfather is rich, bitch. She don't have to marry no slovenly nigga who could wear a bra for money. Now, I'm not talking about Chris. Chris has nice feet. I saw the episode where he was getting a pedicure, and I was like, for a football player, you really have some nice, he got some nice feet. Shout out to Chris Samuels. Oaf, that's not helping you around the house. And I think a lot of people are identifying or choosing to identify with what Monique has going on because of Monique's possessions, and Monique is desirable and to you she's likable. A lot of people relate to Monique I relate to her because this is the life that I want. I want to be married to somebody rich. I want to have a big ass house. I want to have this. I want to be driving fancy cars. So I'm going to identify with her. I don't identify with the girl who's being taken care of by her mother. I don't identify with her and her family. I should stop saying her mother. It's her family. I don't understand why Candace has to make all of these adjustments to her behavior. If you guys know that she gets foul with her mouth, just like if you guys know this girl likes to fight, don't say shit to her. Ashley, if you don't want me to say you're not going to be married for long, mind your business. Stop trying to defend something that happened that you when you were not there to see at all. And I don't like that Chris told her to shut up. Don't tell me to shut up. You can tell me to be quiet. You can tell me to settle down. You can do like how Ray was doing to Karen when Karen was cussing Michael Darby out. Karen, please. That's all you had to do. Chris, don't tell her to shut up in front of nobody. That's the reason why none of those bitches at the table respect her now, because her mother hits her and her husband tells her to shut up. I don't like that. I know he was trying to get her to calm down, but if you know somebody is crazy with their words and reckless with their mouth, don't say shit to them. That's how we could alleviate all of this stuff. But you are in an environment where shading and reading and insulting happens. So, bitch, if I insult you and it hurts your feelings, you shouldn't have said nothing to me. You shouldn't have said nothing to me. Don't say nothing to me. That's all I have to say. I think that I'm done talking about it. Every time Candace does something, well, that's the reason why you got your ass beat. Y'all saying that this woman's mouth is the reason why somebody can fight her. And because somebody can fight her, she can go down to a courthouse. Would I have done that? If I felt like somebody didn't have remorse, I should have done that twice. When somebody put their hands on me, I didn't. And I should have. And I regretted it. Because if you put your motherfucking hands on me, I don't give a fuck if I told you fuck you to your face. You put your hands on me. What's within the law? Me talking shit to you? Are you physically assaulting me? What's within the law? If that's what we're going by, if we're using this system that has fucked over us over for centuries, if we're going to use this system to how we govern each other in our community. So Candace is supposed to let Monique whoop her ass and not do nothing. So we can allow women to get beat up and not do anything to the person who victimized them. Not do nothing. Nothing, especially when you hear the person has no remorse, nothing. And then you want to turn around and say, oh, I got three kids. You had three kids the night at the barn, bitch. What the fuck is wrong with you? You had three kids when you walked into the thing. You had three kids 2 years ago. No, you had two kids 2 years ago when the rumor was started and you decided to sit there and not say nothing to nobody about it. And to sit in your juices and to not say nothing and to not communicate. But you found the space to communicate with Robin, who actually was like provoking you. Bitch, hit me. Hit me, bitch. Not, are you going to drag me? And to me, for you guys to be like, are you going to drag me? That, like I said the other day when I was driving down the street, you're like a Pavlovian dog. You are triggered by words. That means somebody can control you. Somebody has control over you, a dog. And I have control of, no, Erica, I'm just tired of her talking shit. Okay, you want to shut me up by putting your hands on me. I'm going to shut you up by going down to the courthouse. And it's weird how Candace can't have any trauma. She's just supposed to jump out of that. From the embarrassment on national television, getting your ass beat by somebody who you called you a sister. All of these things, Candace can't be embarrassed. Candace can't be in a panic mode. Candace can't be emotionally distressed. She doesn't even, as a black woman, nobody is giving her even space to be harmed. To feel the harm, to process the harm, to process the assault. She has to jump back into it and not talk about it anymore. She can't process being assaulted. She has to be a strong black woman and just don't tell the cops on the person who assaulted you. Don't feel bad about what happened to you. None of that. Don't feel none of that. Just get over it. You talk too much, girl, that just comes with the territory. Getting your ass beat at your job, girl. I wish a motherfucker would. I wish a motherfucker would. Just because Monique lost it, don't say that Candace was taunting her. From my point of view, I didn't see anyone being taunting, assertive, aggressive, or antagonistic. I saw someone trying to diffuse with humor. Monique saw the laughs from the others because Candace was being funny, so she lost it, triggered, and blacked out. And I want y'all to listen to this. This is when her and Robin got into it. And you tell me if it sounds familiar.
Lucha Thaddeo, is that correct?
Yes, girl.
Lucha Thaddeo.
I want y'all to hear this. Oh, no. No. Actually, this was when... This is not the time her and Robin got it. This is another time when she was yelling across the table at... Giselle and Ashley, when they accused her of being drunk and drinking four drinks. And after Ashley apologized in her interview, Ashley says, "Make no mistake, I made no mistake. Monique just got caught." So she didn't really, she to this day believes that Monique had four drinks and that contributed to her falling in a ditch. But here's Monique talking to Karen. She went over to Karen's house. Okay, here she goes.
I owe you an apology. I'm ashamed at my part in that at your party. I should have known better.
You know what? And you do. But you know, you learn something from this. You don't let them pull your string.
Right. If I'm gonna say I'm not gonna talk about something, I'm not gonna talk about it because I know how I blow up, and I should not have even have went there.
You went from 0 to 1,000. I was like, girl,
I was flying off the mouth so much that night. I don't. Things are still coming to me as what I said.
I go to her face. I choke you out with this
unbuttoned.
And she started provoking.
Do it. Please.
Do
That's
it.
That's when I came.
How immature was that?
That was right down the street.
I wasn't going to hit it first because she ain't about to sue me. Her mind be living up in my house. Please.
I feel a cancer.
That's why I don't fool with people who don't have much to lose, because they just reckless as I don't know what. I've been on Charitable Works in the entire DMV for years, and an accusation such as a DUI, that's major. Like, that's serious, because that shows that you have a lack of judgment. I'm trying to turn over a new leaf. I'm trying not to go from 0 to 100 all the time. I'm like, let me just go over
all the time.
75.
Not me, so.
And they trying to push me to that point.
Sound like they got it out for you, Mom.
I swear.
So these are two different times. Monique doesn't need to be on this show. If you can go from 0 to 100 and flip out every single time, you went from 0 to 100, you said it, Karen said it, you rough around the edges, this might not be the environment for you. You might need to be in an environment where fighting is okay. Where physically assaulting or trying to or attempting to physically assault someone isn't frowned upon, is normalized. Like I said, the streets are down on VH1. Over here, when you put your hands on folks, we sue you. This is what we do. And if for somebody who has so much to lose, you would think, they would think about that. Not only do you have your children, you have your home, you have your husband. Your husband is an NFL retiree. We already know how they are about their wives and the image they have to uphold within the NFL. So everybody, you didn't think about that, but Candace is supposed to have that in mind. She's supposed to take that into consideration when she goes down and says, "Hey, this woman assaulted me." I don't care that you guys are saying she got in her face. She didn't get in her face to me. And I think that a lot of people would have this stance. Everybody's like, "Oh, you team Candace, you team Candace." No, I am for whoever was on the other side of what Monique did. Monique was wrong. You happened to Candace. It just so happened to Candace. Candace gets on my goddamn nerves. Just like Robin said, she gets on your nerves. She gets on your nerves. She gets on my nerves. If you go back and watch my old videos, Candace gets on my fucking nerves. All of the women on this show get on my nerves. They all do. But if I'm looking at this at person A and person B, and you telling me what happened is what's happening between these two people, and you telling me that person A responded like this to person B, I don't give a damn what Monique has. I don't give a damn her big brown eyes. I don't give a fuck. But now all of a sudden, Candace is supposed to take the person who she assaulted is supposed to take her into consideration. Bitch, when you was hitting me on top of the head with your fist 3 or 4 times and then wanted to come back after me, bitch, am I supposed to take you into consideration? And you running around Barnes after me, bitch? I wish a motherfucker would. Girl, please. Oh, they got both of their things got thrown out. Okay, they got thrown out. But I bet you know the next time. I bet you know the next time you want to put your hands on people. Girl, we going down to the courthouse to the people with the black robes. We going down there. I bet you know the next time. I bet she learned her lesson. Did Candace learn her lesson? Maybe. No, y'all said she didn't because she flipped off at Ashley. Ashley, now Ashley deserved that little tongue lashing. That was something. That was a little, girl, not for long. Don't fuck with me. You over here defending something you didn't see. And now we in a fight because you said I've been aggressive towards you, bitch, when you was in my motherfucking house and I told your ass to get the fuck out my house twice. And you came back in with your entitled ass in my shit. If I shot you, bitch, I would be within the law. So don't use that because you were being antagonistic. And that, what Ashley did at that table was antagonism. I'm antagonizing you because you're sitting here talking about you being, you know, assaulted. It wasn't one-sided. Well, even with Robin and Monique, when they got into it, Robin's like, you know what? No, it wasn't one-sided. I, you know, engaged you. I was going back and forth, but I don't even know why you came at me because I didn't even say anything about you. The fact that you went to Robin to the point where you're going to put an umbrella under her neck and it was between you and Ashley. Ashley is the one. And I'm going to tell you this, since I've been watching these Potomac housewives, Ashley and Giselle, it's something with them too. I don't know what it is, but it's something with Ashley and Giselle, and they keep the shit going and they keep it going. And Charisse is not even on the show, honey, and she keeps the shit going. And we saw at the reunion when Monique was pregnant, her and Charisse had already fell out. They had already fallen out. Because Charisse thought you was trying to get her contacts. You cozied up to Charisse, your sister, and you was getting her contacts. And that's when you brought Kendall on the show and you tried to blame Charisse for it. You another dog control dog move. So you need to go and relax for a season and then come back, Monique, because you need to figure out, maybe you need whoever helped Nene with her reads. Call some girls and get your reads together, honey. Call some of your, call your brother and Hank. Is Hank gay? I don't know. Because you don't know how to read a girl down. You want to fight. And we're seeing a pattern of behavior here. And you're always triggered. And I'm trying to figure out when Giselle triggered you so many seasons ago, how come you haven't worked on those triggers? Because now Giselle didn't get the brunt. Robin didn't get the brunt. Ashley didn't get the brunt. Charisse didn't get the brunt. But little Candace with the big mouth, she got all of your venom, all of it. And for what? The bitch who started the rumor needs her ass beat. If you're going to beat anybody's ass, Charisse. Hello? But Candace gets it because Candace should bear some loyalty to you. The same loyalty you should have bore to her when you showed Ashley the text messages between you and her. When she was talking about Michael as if your ass wasn't talking about Michael too, bitch. We got you, Monique. Bye, Monique. Bye, Monique. We sleep. We're bored. You still making up shit and we're still bored, girl. Take care of each other. Protect your energy. Peace.